It's a party that's committed to turning domestic terrorists into martyrs and freedom fighters. Last word to you, Stuart. If we don't do this, then what happens, in your view?
Well, look, I think it's our inability to imagine what will happen, which is our greatest danger. It is a replay of 9/11, and we cannot imagine what could, this attack on America. And we have to get out of that.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. I swear, I watch this every day, and I don't understand why this gargoyle is allowed to go on national TV every night and essentially incite political violence. Because that's exactly what's happening here. Don't kid yourselves. They want Antifa, BLM, or some lone wolf to start taking violent actions against Republicans and their supporters. And we do have proof that they do this, and it works. When they started calling ICE detention centers concentration camps, it resulted in multiple attacks on ICE facilities. When they called Republicans monsters that want you to die because of their opposition to Obamacare, a lone gunman attempted to assassinate half the GOP Senate while yelling, "This is for healthcare." And we saw the fruits of this incitement over the last year and a half with BLM and Antifa riots across the country. Conveniently, the media always lets those examples fall down the memory hole, while every night it's a drumbeat of manufactured lies against Republicans. Now, we have a lot more to go over about this segment, but first, give me just a moment to tell you about this special offer for my viewers. These days, the future is still more uncertain than ever. That's why people who know what's coming are using today to prepare. You can't wait until the last moment. By then, it's too late. The most important thing you need is long-term storage emergency food. It stays fresh for up to 25 years and will be there when you need it. I strongly recommend My Patriot Supply, America's leader in self-reliance. They're the only source my family uses for emergency food planning. And right now, you can save $50 off a four-week supply of delicious meals that provide 2,000 plus calories a day. Calories give you the energy you need to survive. And saving $50 is impossible to pass up, but supplies are limited. So go to www.preparewithdronetech.com right now and stock up. That's preparewithdronetech.com. There's no time to lose. Do it now.
What is happening to the Republican Party? Our democracy is currently under siege by one of our two major political parties. A party that, thanks to Donald Trump's rabbit hole of conspiracy theories, white grievance, and an unquenchable thirst for absolute power, embraces causes that were once viewed as fringe.
Okay, I'm gonna have to stop and refute some of this outlandish, insane crap that she's saying. I mean, fringe? You mean like socialism, Marxism, and communism that are all now mainstream concepts on the left and in the Democrat Party? You mean like drag queen story time? You mean like opening borders and defunding police? Those kind of fringe concepts? We all know she's not talking about the party that's currently in power and that basically controls all of America's institutions and means of free speech in the public square. The party in power that has a massive state media complex to promote and protect all of their agenda while constantly putting their opposition on the defensive. Republicans control nothing and are out of power. Republicans are even afraid to go out and protest because the media and the president are constantly demonizing them as terrorists. We're talking about a party that flees democracy when it's not working to advance their agenda or when they don't win the election. Seriously, these nutcases believe that if they don't win an election, if they're not in power, then democracy has died.
Democracy held is what the president said. His exact words. Democracy held.
Democracy held in 2020, Eamon, but the fear among President Biden and many Democrats here is that it may not in 2022 and 2024.
See? It's like I always say and have said for years. Democrats think the only legitimate election is one that they win.
Banning books, or really any idea that doesn't render every single white American in history going all the way back to 1619 and right up to today as innocent and benevolent, even as a noose literally hung outside the U.S. Capitol just 6 months ago.
The complete lack of self-awareness just leaves me stupefied. Like, there are people out there that hear this and think to themselves, yeah, she's really onto something here. For one, all the things she just listed there are things that Democrats are actually doing and Republicans are not doing. They're the ones banning books. Her claims about Republicans wanting to ban books that don't show white Americans in a heroic light is just a completely made-up straw man. We've all learned about how horrible white people are in school. We're beat over the head with it from a young age, and you know what? We take it because we just want to get along, and we understand that there were evils committed in history. But that wasn't enough. Now they want to broadly generalize, judge, and assign traits to people based on nothing but their skin color. And then blame those people for everything bad that's ever happened. I mean, it's literally institutionalized racism. And I just love how she brings up this one noose at one right-leaning rally 6 months ago as if it's something out of the norm. Nooses, guillotines, and burning politicians in effigy is a staple of left-wing protest. But as always is the case, it's different when they do it.
What kind of atmosphere has been created by this zeal against history, against voting?
What evidence has she or any of these people ever presented that Republicans, quote, have a zeal against history or voting? What evidence is there at all that having to have a voter ID is going to keep anybody from voting? Laws like this have been around for a long time in states like Delaware, where Joe Biden is from, and nobody ever claimed that he was trying to stifle voting. Again, it's Democrats who are tearing down American history and using communist mobs to do it. It's Democrats who hate the American flag and want to replace it. It's Democrats who hate the Constitution and want to replace it. It's Democrats that are actively creating an environment where Democrats can never lose an election, their opposition has no voice, and those who do oppose Democrats are called racist terrorists that should be treated like the Taliban.
It's a party that's committed to turning domestic terrorists into martyrs and freedom fighters.
Look, I think it's our inability to imagine what will happen, which is our greatest danger. It is a replay of 9/11, and we cannot imagine what could, this attack on America. And we have to get out of that.
This is truly some CIA-level psyop shit that we're witnessing here. I have no other explanation for it. What exactly are they defending against? What evidence did they present to back up any of their accusations? All right, folks, I think I'm done. These Orwellian nightmares aren't good for the mind or soul. But then again, if I didn't make these videos and vent, I'd probably have a psychotic breakdown. Which I think is the point of gaslighting, isn't it? Or at the very least, to demoralize us from even standing up for ourselves. As always, thanks for watching. Hit that like button on your way out and let me know what you think about this video in the comment section.